This is just a continuation from my previous probability video, and this time we are going to compare these two questions, and we are going to pay close attention to the setups. Okay, the first one, we have two dice and we are going to roll them together at the same time. This is the same situation like last time, even though I didn't mention at the same time, but I did talk about we roll both of them, right? Anyway, we are going to find the probability that one of them is a 6, given that the other one is a 4. Well, if you look at the second question, we only have one die and we are going to roll it twice. And we are going to find the probability that the second roll is a 6, given that the first roll was a 4. And if you just compare these two questions, they sound similar, isn't it? But as always, I will let you guys to pause the video and try to think about these two questions first. And I would actually like to tell you guys what the answers are first. The answer to this one is just like what we did last time. It's 2 over 11. And the answer to the second one, in fact, we do not get the same answer. This right here is precisely just 1 over 6. Okay? And now, let me just go through these two questions with you guys. For the first one, let's look at the setup. We are going to roll two dice at the same time. We have two dice, and we are going to roll both of them. Okay, the same situation, the same setup like the previous video. Based on this, I will draw you guys a sample space. Okay, so these are the possible outcomes that we may have. So of course, we have a total of 6 times 6, namely 36 outcomes. Okay, suppose we didn't have this given information, and as I talked about it last time, the given information is what we call the conditional probability. Okay. But anyway, suppose we didn't have the given information. If the question is asking you, what's the probability that one of the die is a 6 and the other one is a 4? This means we are talking about this box right here, because this right here is 4 and 6. And likewise, this box, because this box also gives you 4 and 6. So this box means that we have the 6 in blue and then the 4 in red. And this box means that we have the 4 in blue and the 6 in red, right? So the answer to just that, it would be 2 out of 36, okay? Now, right here, we do have the given information, so it's actually different. Because we are given that one of the dice is a 4. This is the idea. Imagine that when you roll the dice, you have been covered, okay? Your eyes have been covered, so you don't know what it is. So you just roll the die like this. And then somebody tells you, hey, black pen, red pen, one of the dice, it's a 4. When you know that, instead of a total of 36 possible outcome, because somebody told you this information, you actually get to narrow the sample space down to this right here, because you want one of them to be a 4, or this right here, because maybe the real one is a 4. So instead of 36 possible outcome, if you didn't know any given information, but once we do, you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Do not count this box twice, okay? So because of the given information, you are narrowing down to this and that for the sample space, you only have a total of 11 possible outcome now, thanks to the person who told you the one of them is a 4. You have been covered, so you don't know, but thanks to that. Now, I will guess the other one is a 6. I will be successful to guess that with a probability of 2 over 11, because I have two boxes, namely here and here, right? The other one is a 6, 2 out of 11. So that's it. Okay, so this is good. Now, what's the difference between this one and that one? This right here is, of course, we only have one die and we roll twice. When we roll the first time, we see that the result was a 4. So this is kind of like conditional probability as well. And if you would like, you can write this down. We would like to find out the probability that the second roll is a 6, so the second is a 6, given that the first row was a 4. So of course, you roll the first time and you see it, haha, it's a 4, right? But the problem with this is that once you finish rolling the first time, you get a 4, you picked out the die, and you're going to roll it again. You have to ask yourself, what's the probability that when you roll the dice the second time, you get a 6? In fact, this and that have nothing to do with each other, and in the probability sense, we call that these two events are independent. Independent. I'm not talking about linearly independent, that's linear algebra or differential equation. I'm talking about probability. These two events are independent, meaning that when you get a 4 the first time, it has nothing to do with getting a 6 with the second row, okay? So, if you want to put this down right here with the notation I introduced last time, this right here is just equal to the probability of getting the second row equal to 6. So, you have the die in your hand the second time. What's the probability? You roll this time, you get a 6. It's precisely one side out of a total of 6 sides. So it's just 1 over 6, okay? And you might be wondering, why did I really have to say the second row is a 6, given the first row was a 4? Why could I not say, given the second row was a 4? It doesn't even make sense. Because this has to happen second after that. So given the first row, that's the only possible way, right? And you might also want to draw the sample space, okay? But you don't really have to draw any sample space for the output of the first one, because you know it's a 4 already. Don't why bother? If you want, you can just draw, haha, this is a 4. That's it. You know the first row is a 4, so you don't really have to do anything with it. And if you would like, you can just pretty much put this down 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, right? And you have talking about 1 out of 6. You know the first row right here give you the 4 already, so it's 100%. This right here, it's the second row, right? It's 1 over 6. So the deal is, if these two are independent, I almost wanted to say linearly independent, but no. If these two are independent, you are just trying to get the probability of getting the second row to be a 6. The first row, you know 100% already, it's a 4 because you know it. But anyway, hopefully this right here clears the questions that you guys may have from the previous video. And this is perhaps the biggest difference between this answer versus that answer, the setup and then the independency, and also look at the sample space and things like that.